join me. Together, we can rule the galaxy far from sun.
I am a Jedi, like my father before me.
This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them.
Right. This is Big T and Little T, a Star Wars podcast. Welcome to episode 89. Today we're going to be talking about chapter 6 of the Book of Boba Fett, titled From the Desert Comes a Stranger. Wow, can't wait to talk about this one. Unfortunately, my little buddy Little T could not be here today, but he will be back shortly. We got a special episode planned very shortly to bring him back. I'm Todd Hoffman, and welcome to today's show. Before we get into the Book of Boba, been a crazy week. We had a birthday party celebration. It was my dad's birthday, my wife's birthday, Jen, and Trent's birthday, all in January. So we had like this huge celebration, and it was super fun and to hang out with family. And so we did that, which was great. You know, Trent got some Xbox cards, so he's all ready to buy some Xbox games, but we haven't done that yet. But yeah, he made out right. He got some clothes and all that good stuff. He got this really cool Funko Pop with Luke and baby Grogu. So cool. It looked great. Grogu is like super tiny and it's fantastic. So he got that, which was kind of cool. A little cool Star Wars thing. Watched the WWE Royal Rumble this weekend. It was on a Saturday. It was Saturday, what was that? The 29th? Am I saying that right? Maybe? Kind of? I'm not sure. Yeah, the 29th. And it's the first pay-per-view, our first Royal Rumble on the old Peacock. And so that is where WWE stuff is streaming right now. It was not bad. Royal Rumble is for me like the best gimmick that WWE has. I love the idea of every 2 minutes, you know, another wrestler comes in, and they had both a 30 man and a 30 woman Royal Rumble. But they also, you know, they also had some preliminary matches. So we had the first one was Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins going at it, and Seth came in and the old Shield music, but Reigns got the upper hand but was disqualified by using a chair, so nothing happened with the title. Then we had let's see what else was going on. It was there was a couple other good matches. I mean, like Becky Lynch versus Dewdrop was okay. Brock Lesnar versus Bobby Lashley, two heavyweights, and Brock kind of got the upper hand here, but then Roman came in and Paul Heyman kind of turned on Brock, and it was Bobby pinned him. Yeah, it was all kinds of things. The really cool match was Edge and Beth Phoenix versus Miz and Marcy, and this one was awesome. Edge and Beth Phoenix looked amazing, and they took on, it's kind of like power couples. It was a super good match, super fun mixed tag, a lot of energy, and it was super awesome. The Royal Rumble is all about like some legends coming in and some gimmick stuff, and there's always good stuff going on. And honestly, this one kind of fell flat for me. It wasn't the best Royal Rumble I've seen. There was, I guess, some surprises, but I don't know. Like, there wasn't too many like, oh my gosh, this is amazing, like when Cena came back or anything like that. The only one that was a surprise is that Brock came in at 30 and basically cleaned house, and yeah, he's got a title. So I don't know if he's going back after Roman, and you know, I don't know. The WWE product for me is like kind of dwindling a little bit. I love A&W and what they're doing. The one big surprise, I guess, would be Johnny Knoxville came in for a little bit and got hammered, you know, and then Shane McMahon came in. Bad Bunny was another kind of guest that showed up. But yeah, it was wasn't like that, like, oh my gosh, it's amazing. The women's tag team was pretty good. Or Royal Rumble was good. Ronda Rousey came back. And yeah, so there's a couple other kind of legends or Hall of Famers that came back, but nothing like, again, like, whoa, this is amazing. So kind of, I would say, subpar, if you would, for a Royal Rumble. Still fun. Wrestling's still fun. Love wrestling. It's always good to see it. But yeah, like, that's one of the cool things that we like to do. Trent and I was watching on the kind of network on just watching some old Royal Rumble stuff, and it's great. I love Royal Rumble, but this one, ugh, not the best. But all right, we got something to talk about. It's chapter 6. From the desert comes a stranger. That is a mouthful, but this is probably one of the best Star Wars shows ever. But for Book of Boba Fett show, there's not a lot of Boba in this one. But let's just take a look at what's going on. So the premise is we're back on Tatooine. We got a little Marshal and some Pikes, and they're doing some shady stuff with the spice. And the Marshal gets a drop on them, but basically says, "Hey, Mos Espa, you don't mess around." And yeah, they leave the spice, but yeah, it's just like, hey, this is my territory. This is why I don't bet on sports, and this is why I don't bet on what's gonna happen in these shows. You think you got it all figured out, and I was clearly wrong about last week where I said, Grogu's not gonna show up. That's gonna be in season 3 of Mandalorian. But yep, the Grogu does show up. It's kind of crazy. And yeah, it's like right away. So Din gets in a ship and he's off to see his buddy Grogu. And he goes to, you know, this is where, again, I wish they took a little bit of Rogue One and like put the planet name on the bottom. It'd be great. But they don't. It's okay. I'll live with it. But it's foresty kind of planet, and so goes his planet. They don't really say how he knows that Grogu's there, but he knows where to go. He lands. Our boy R2's there. He's got the little radar dish like from Empire. It's legit. Our boy R2, and now, you know, the progression of Din with droids is fantastic. He's, hey, little buddy, I'm trying to find my man Grogu. So we get to this part where we see all these droids, and they're like literally like R2 ant droids or something, and they're building a temple. The temple looks very from like Ahch-To with their little fish nuns. It has that kind of same feel. If you're not familiar with like what George does with these kind of Jedi temples, but like these bell shaped things, it's all through kind of the Ralph McQuarrie design and Doug Chang. So this temple has that look and feel of what we saw in Ahch-To. It's very cool. Very Ralph McQuarrie, very Doug Chang. It's awesome. So they're building this temple. And so R2 shuts down like he does in The Force Awakens. And the ants droids build him a little bed, and Din just kind of lays down on the bench. And then he gets awoken, and it's Ahsoka Tano. You're like, what the heck is going on here? But there's Ahsoka, and it's like, hey, you want to, you know, talk to, he wants to talk to Grogu and all this stuff. And, yeah, it's like all this kind of cool stuff. But before we get to Ahsoka, there's a little part and we get Luke Skywalker in the flesh, kind of, deep faked out or whatever. And Grogu, and they have this like little, moment, and yeah, all the Grogu Luke stuff is fantastic. Looking about meditation, Grogu gets distracted by her one-eyed frog. He tries to use the Force, and then Luke is like using all the Force to lift up the frog. So we got multiple frogs, kind of like an X-wing, but you know, it's the same thing. But then we have Luke talking to Grogu about the Force, and then he mentions Yoda, and we get Yoda's theme, and he's like lifting Grogu up with the Force, and all this bit is like it's great, it's fantastic. Luke looks fantastic, it's great, it's awesome. Yeah, so we have this kind of thing there, which is awesome. And then right then, no Bacta tank this time, we get another flashback. So Luke he's trying to really unlock Grogu's abilities. There's some, you would almost say like PTSD, where like he's not fully committed to the Force, but it's kind of there. And so Luke puts his hand on Grogu's little head, and we get this little kind of cool like Force wave, and then it kind of fades into a flashback, and we go back to the siege, Order 66, the siege of the Jedi Temple. We got clone troopers ripped from Return of the Jedi, or Revenge of the Sith. Yes. Yep. And we have the 501st troopers taking out the Jedi, and Grogu is seen like three Jedi try to defend him, and there's the clone troopers taking him out, the 501st doing their deal, and that's it. Fade to black, and we get back to present time, and Luke's like, I'll teach you how to defend yourself. So then that's when our boy Din is woken up by R2 and Ahsoka, and we have this little chat with Ahsoka and Din, and he wants to give him the gift, and we don't know what the gift is, but he's like, hey man, I'm just in around, and it's alluded that R2 kind of diverted him to Ahsoka instead of going right to Luke. So R2's smart, he's on the down low, man, he's got it. So he does this. It's so good. It's like he's like, I come all this way and I want to give him this gift. But Ahsoka's like, if he sees you, it's going to kind of be a setback in his training. And, you know, there's a strong bond with you guys. And that's why I didn't want to do it. And that's why Luke is kind of taking the mantle. And yeah, it's just, he's like, but he's right there. And it's like, oh my gosh, it tugs at your heartstring. So you can see him on the hill meditating with Luke. And yeah, it's just great. But then he kind of takes Ahsoka's wisdom. And then he's like, yeah, I'm out. See ya. Thanks. And he drops off the Mandalorian armor and he gets out of here. So now we get this cool kind of Dagobah training sequence, but now it's like Luke teaching Yoda or baby Grogu. We got lightsabers and Luke looks so cool with his black G and he's like just like living life. And we get a little backpack action. We got Force training. We get training remotes and Grogu can't jump, but then he jumps and then he's doing all the stuff, and yeah, we got cool like little Star Wars water buffalo and all this kind of Japanese anime stuff that Uncle Dave is just throwing in our face. And then there's this really cool moment where they kind of go above the trees and he's like, this, you know, feel the force, this force, you know, that the force is present in this planet. And it's just so anime, very Visions like, if you will, because that's also anime. And so they kind of go through all this training, and but then they have this moment where Grogu destroys the training remote and then takes a nap. You know, it's classic Grogu. And Luke asks Ahsoka, you know, I don't know what to do with them. And Ahsoka says, trust your instincts. And it's like, and then Ahsoka's like, yeah, I'm out. See ya. Have a good time. And he's like, here, you know, she's like, here's the armor that, or the gift that, you know, Din dropped off. So now we go back to Din. He flies into Tatooine. He's got, you know, his boy shows, you know, he shows up. The Piggy's like, hey, man, what are you doing here? Piggy takes him in, and we got a whole little huddle, again, talking about the Pikes invading, Boba's territory and what's going on at Tatooine, all that kind of stuff. So we get a little shout out to our Black Krasanin, our little mod troops, you know, and we got the Major Domo and Shackles, all that fun stuff. So Din's like, I might got a guy. So then we know he goes to the Marshal. Marshal's there. Marshal says this really cool line. He's like, hey, where's the little guy? And he's like, he's with his people. And he's like, we lost something we both very fond of. So Marshal with his armor, and then obviously Grogu with Din. Such a cool line. So Din's like, hey, man, I need help. It's not easy asking for a favor, but I need this, you know, favor. I need help with Boba Fett to take out these Pikes. And Marshall's already seen the Pikes, so he knows that they're not playing, and they're running spice through his town, and they're going to be taking over, Mos Espa and all that kind of stuff, and everywhere else, basically. So we have all that going on. And then so he's like, okay, I'm gonna call a meeting, because now, you know, it's not, they call it Freetown now because of the liberation that they did with the Cryo Dragon. We also got this cool real talk about the Cryo Dragon. Inside the bar now is like the rib cage of the Cryo Dragon, and then we got some Jawas on a sandcrawler with the big old skull. Very impractical, but so sci-fi. They got a big old Kyrate dragon skull on the sandcrawler. Why not? You know, so like the upper jaw of the sandcrawler. It's great. So we got that going on, and it's like, hey, let's he's gonna call in the town folk and say, hey, let's talk about this, because I think we need to fight. The bartender and a couple other patrons are like, this is Freetown. We don't need to be worried about Pikes and all that kind of stuff. So Din takes off. Boom. He's out. And here's where it gets fun. So now we have a kind of real quick shot of like a wind chime. But you could tell that the wind has changed a little bit. And then, you know, Marshall kind of turns, and then the camera shows, and we got this lone figure walking in the desert. I looked right away with the duster. I'm like, I looked at Trent. I'm like, could it be Cad Bane? And as it got closer, I'm like, I think it's Cad Bane. And it was Cad Bane. So there's a lot of controversy already that Cad Bane doesn't look like the Clone Wars version. I am fine with the Cad Bane that we got. It looks great. Again, the Clone Wars version is a characterization of the Duros, and, you know, again, Anakin Skywalker and Obi-Wan and Count Dooku do not look like their real life counterparts, so I kind of like this more real world Duros. Cad Bane looks great. He basically says, hey, Pikes run this town, get out of my way, don't get in my way. Boba Fett is a cold-blooded killer, and he worked for the Empire. Yada yada yada, stay out of the business. And then we got like kind of this deputy guy that was trying to give Din some trouble, and now is like looking at Cobb Vanth, looking at Cad Bane, and he tries to get the jump. Obviously, He shoots both the marshal and this deputy. The deputy's totally dead. I think the marshal's still alive. I think he just got hit in the shoulder. Again, he's not a stormtrooper, so of course he's alive. Humans can take laser bullets. Stormtroopers can't. That's a discussion for a different day. But yeah, there we go. And then after we get the Cad Bane thing, we go back to the sanctuary. We got two pikes coming in. They got the Camtono with them, and they just leave it. And it's like, oh boy, here we go. There's legit this cool synth music that's going on in the sanctuary. The pikes don't want their helmets cleaned. That's the only thing that these Twi'leks can say, I guess. I don't know, the two other Twi'leks and Garsha's there. But the droid picks up the Camtono, and it blow up. I hope Garsha's not dead. There was no Max Rebo. They made sure to show no Max Rebo. I think Max is still alive. Long live the Max. Long live the King. Max Rebo is still alive, I believe. So we had that going on. And then we go back to where Luke and Grogu at. We have this cool, the temple is built now. There are one temple building is built, and they're in there, and more nostalgia. We have Luke has Yoda's lightsaber, and he lays out Grogu's the Din gift, which is this kind of chain mithril looking, kind of like Mando armor. It's very thin, but it's got kind of like that chain mesh mithril thing going on. And he's like, "You got to make a choice. Either I train you as a Jedi, or you go back with Din." And that's it. Episode's end. And it's like, what the heck? So this is really the first time I've watched a Boba Fett twice. I just adored this show. Dave knows what he's doing. It's fantastic. It looks great. It hits all the bells and whistles of everything you need in a Star Wars show. And, you know, we have all these kind of cool things. But there's no Boba Fett. It's the Book of Boba Fett. There's no Boba Fett. So being a Boba Fett fan and a lifelonger here, I'm having a difficult time. Like, this is called Book of Boba Fett, but why don't you just call it like the prequel to Mandalorian Season 3 or whatever? I'm hoping we get a little bit more Boba Fett next week as the finale. But from a Star Wars perspective, oh, it's so yummy and so good. But yeah, just need a little Boba Fett. We're looking for, you know, the character of Boba Fett. It kind of reminds me of like Captain America, the third one. I think it's Captain America Civil War, if I'm not mistaken. I think that's it, the third one or whatever. And it's like, yeah, Captain America's in it, but really it's like an Avengers movie. And I feel like that's what's going on here is like, yeah, that's a Boba Fett show, but we got Luke and Grogu and, you know, some of the stuff I feel like we would get in Season 3 of Mandalorian. But I got a couple theories. So, you know, the big thing is like, you know, Mando needs an army. So I'm very sure that our Freetown people are going to come and help out. But that, I don't know if that's going to help with the pikes. So one of the things I think is that it really is going to establish that Cad Bane killed the Tusken Raider camp. So it wasn't really the riders, the swoop bike guys. And I don't think Din is going to go back to get Grogu, because I think Grogu is going to make the choice to stay with Din and not train. And so I think Luke is going to come to Tatooine. And then there's the Boba Fett thing. There's the Cad Bane thing. There's a lot of different things going on. So I'm hoping we get more than an hour for the season finale. It's going to head up good, but it's got to end in kind of a cliffhanger, or at least tease for either Ahsoka or Season 3 of Mandalorian. So my hot take is that Grogu gets captured, or Grogu by Cad Bane, or Grogu gets shot, kind of like a Frodo thing where we feel like Frodo gets stabbed and he's like, oh, he's dead, but he's got the mithril underneath him. I think the same thing is going to happen where the audience knows that Yoda or Baby Grogu is safe, but he might look dead to the others because they don't know he's got that Mando armor going on. I don't know. The one thing that's very interesting about Luke's question is it's very similar to what we saw in Empire, where he had a choice. Both Yoda and Obi-Wan are like, yeah, your friends can wait. You need to train because Darth Vader is like really, really bad. And we need you a little bit more in the hot yoga Dagobah thing training course, you know? But Luke sees that in the Force, this vision that his friends are in trouble, and he chooses his friends over the Jedi training. So the fact that Luke is trying to be dogmatic in the sense of dealing with absolutes, I thought Sith only deal with absolutes, but he says either you do this or that. And really, I think it's kind of a combination of both. Or is it more of a test where he knows that his heart is within and his friends, just like Luke's heart was with his friends, and he still became a Jedi. So, yeah, it's not convoluted, but it's definitely something that Luke, I think, is testing Grogu on. But I really do feel Grogu is going to get his choice and do dead. I mean, they teased it with the Naboo Starfighter. He's got the baby seat in the back. It's going to happen. We know it's going to happen. But I don't think Din's going back, and that's why I feel like Luke is going to come back to Tatooine, his homeworld, and maybe help the people, and maybe even Boba Fett, even though he kind of helped put Boba Fett in the Sarlacc. Whatever. We'll see. It's just so chock full of, like, Dave goodness, but like I said, I just need a little bit more Boba Fett in next week. Please. Thank you. I want to see Boba Fett, like, in some, you know, action or whatever, you know, that kind of stuff. So there you have it. That is chapter 6 of the Book of Boba Fett, and it was a hoot. I love everything that it brought up from a Star Wars perspective, and just the motivation of the characters, and what is Grogu going to do, and how is that going to affect this outcome that we're seeing on Tatooine. I still think the Pikes are not the big bad. The real kind of cameo I'm looking for is Kira with Crimson Dawn. I want something bigger than the Pikes, but you know what we got so far is just crazy. It's just crazy. So we'll see next week. So there you have it. All right. Thank you, Space Wizards, Plastic Spacemen, and Rebel Princesses for listening to another episode of Big T and Little T, a Star Wars podcast. You can find us on the socials, Big T, Little T Podcast on Instagram, B-L-I-L-T Podcast on the Twitter, and here on Twitch, twitch.tv/ Big T and Little T. Trent and I are starting to stream a little bit more, play a lot of Madden, and just a lot of fun like that. So check that out as well. We just got a lot of snow, so we got the RC car out again, so we're gonna make a couple more videos of that. Hopefully we won't get too much more snow in Chicago, but if we do, we will have our tauntauns ready and ready to go out there and have some fun in the snow. Hey, we got some stickers and some swag we want to give to you. So if you comment, tweet, rate us on Apple Podcast, or give us a like on a rating on Spotify, you can do that now. Take a screenshot and send it to bigtlittletpodcast@gmail.com. We would love to read your review and share that on our next podcast. Or if you have a Star Wars question, or you want to give your theories on what's going to happen in Chapter 7 of Book of Boba Fett, drop us a line at bigtlittletpodcast@gmail.com, and we will definitely read it on an upcoming episode. So there you go. Now, there's only one way to end this. Truly wonderful the mind of a child is, and may the Force be with you always. Bye. Peace, peace, peace. We'll see you later, guys. Bye.
be so hasty now, boy.
Let them go, Bane. This isn't their fight anymore.
Always fighting for those in need. That's a quick way to wind up poor or dead. And probably both.
No more innocent people are going to die. All be locked up, all live in fear.
Looks like your little insurrection has failed. Now surrender, and I'll let your friends walk away.
I say, they give the kid his shot.
So that's it. Just you and me then.
Yes, it is.
Test 1 2 1 2